For this session, we have the head coach and captain of Team India with us. I'll just quickly take you through the guidelines for this interaction. Media participants will all be muted during the session. All the questions shall be asked via chat box in English, so please do that, guys. Please set your name as your full name and media organization. Please state your question, indicating the person it's directed to, that is over here, the coach or the captain. And we'll get questions from the AFC first and then move on to the media. There's ample time, so there's no need to rush through. Please separate out your questions if you need to. I'll first go to the coach. Coach, it's been a long time coming, this tournament. There's a lot of preparation that has gone into this. How do you gauge the team's state of being and preparation for the event?
Yeah, I'm happy with the preparation so far. We have been working very hard for a long time. When we summarized it a couple of days ago, we see that we have done over 200 sessions since we started in August. And that comes with football sessions, tactical, technical sessions, strength sessions, running sessions. And yeah, all players are fit, so everything is good in the squad. So we are happy that they choose to start now because it's been a long time waiting. So, yeah, we really focused on the game on Thursday.
Thank you, coach. Also, for Asha, you have achieved success as a player with club and country. How challenging or different is this tournament going to be for you?
You can answer anything.
ये मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ा challenges है और ये हमारे country के लिए और team के लिए बहुत बड़ा opportunity है ये AFC और क्योंकि ये एशियन कप की वजह से हमें एक बहुत बड़ा हॉटस्पॉट होने वाले इंडिया में वुमेन्स फुटबॉल को लेके सो हमारे लिए ये सबसे मेरा बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है ये और आगे बढ़ के लेके जाने का इंडिया टीम को और मुझे इस एएफसी कप से और भी हमें और बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलने वाले है क्योंकि हमें क्वार्टर फाइनल तक पहुंच गया और अच्छा रीजन परफॉर्म कर रहे थे तो हमें वर्ल्ड कप क्वालिफाई होने का बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलने वाले है सो ये मेरे लिए और टीम के लिए और इंडिया के लिए बहुत बड़ा चैलेंजेस है.
Thank you, Asha. For the non-Hindi speaking media, we'll get this now translated from the team media officer of India.
So Ashulata is saying it's a big challenge obviously for us, but it is also a very big opportunity. We are hoping that the Asian Cup being hosted in India, it will create a big hotspot for women's football in our country. And of course, it will be a huge challenge for us, but it's also the opportunity comes in with regards to if we qualify for the quarterfinal, we have a chance of qualifying for the FIFA World Cup next year. And that will be huge and enormous for Indian football.
Thank you, Asha. We have a question from Ashwati Santosh from Halfway Football. Team India has gotten a very good preparation ahead of the Asian Cup, coach, and playing at the home is an added advantage. What is the team's objective going into the competition? And facing newcomers Iran in the first match, how difficult do you think it's going to be for you?
First of all, our target, our goal for this tournament is definitely to come to the quarterfinal. We think we have a realistic chance to do that. On the second question, the Iran game is going to be a really tough one. We have followed them on videos and so on, and they are really fighting. They play with a heart, a strong defense, a strong block, good defending around their own box and so on. And going to be a challenge for us to score. But I hope that the pace of the game, the level we have in the passing game and the creative players we have can open up that block and that we can create good chances and also have a winning goal. But if anyone thinks there's going to be an easy game, definitely not. It's going to be a really tough game and we have to have a good performance to win that game.
Thank you, coach. That does answer a lot of questions of the game against Iran. There's a specific question about your team composition from Unnati. She asks, with Baladevi out, who are your potent striking options? Where do you see the goals coming in from?
Yeah, we have a lot of players that can both create chances and score goals. All our top forwards, whoever will stop the game, are good in the finishing situation. So, but the easy answer is the boring answer. The one that have get the ball in the right situation should take the chance and score. It's not easy to predict before who's the one that's going to get the chance, but the one that get the chance have to execute well.
That's a fair answer, coach, right there. There's another question about your group, and what are your impressions of the group that you have trained now over a while? How do you think the team has developed under you and your tenure over here?
First of all, already when I arrived, there was a really good group of football players, so whoever been there before me have done a good job. But of course, when you come as a new coach, you always have your own philosophy and you have your idea how you want the girls to play. But now, in this short time, as like we have 4 or 5 months to prepare, of course, you can't do everything at the same time. So if you come to the defending game, it was more to start playing more like a good unit with close distances between and width and depth and all that, and how to pressure, when to pressure, and when to drop off and so on and all that. And attacking game, more about, I think in the beginning when I arrived, we played a little bit too many long balls. And it's good, and we're going to do sometimes also. But now we're trying to create a little bit more crucial passes from midfield. So it's not so far distance when you send the penetration passes behind the opponent's defending line and so on. So, and of course, the fitness level. We have worked very hard with the fitness level. Because when you play a tournament like this, game every third day, you need to be prepared so you come fully loaded to game 2 and game 3, and hopefully game 4, 5 and 6 also.
And Asha, a corresponding question for you. Your team has, you and the whole team has played against some big teams in the near past. Your impressions on that, how has that prepared you for this tournament? And do you think you're better placed now to face the rigors of a continental competition like this?
Yeah, obviously, क्योंकि हमने पिछले जो exposure trip था उसमें बहुत better country के साथ खेला था और बहुत अच्छे Europe के players के साथ खेलने का मौका मिला था और उसकी वजह से हमारे confidence level और बहुत सारे technique tactics level में भी बहुत सारे changes हुई है क्योंकि हमें अभी पता चला है कि इस level के player के साथ किस तरीका के game खेलना हमारे लिए better होगा और team के लिए अच्छा रहेगा. ये सब चीज़ें में हमें हेल्प कर रहे हैं. सो ये AFC में भी और जो भी टीम आएंगे उसमें भी हमें जो पिछले वाले जो मैचेस है उससे काफ़ी इम्प्रूव होगा.
ओके, सो आशा इज सेइंग दैट ऑब्वियसली द एक्सपोजर ट्रिप्स, सो आशा इज सेइंग दैट द एक्सपोजर ट्रिप्स दैट द टीम हैज़ डन इन द लीड अप टू द AFC एशियन कप have obviously helped the entire team grow as a squad together. They've had exposure trips in Europe and South America and played against some physically challenging and tactically challenging teams and learned a lot from them as well. Learned how to play against tougher opponents, tougher players as teams and as individuals. And these matches have obviously helped the team to grow together and learn to play against such opponents and will further help them against the opponents in the AFC Asian Cup.
A follow-up question on this, coach, really is from Mihir from the Indian Express, and it basically asks along similar lines of what Asha mentioned. You have played a lot of friendlies recently, but this is a competition. This is a competition with very high stakes and a lot of quality. How is the team prepared for this?
Hopefully we are prepared in a good way, but for all of us, I'm talking about players now, all of the players, it's the first time you come into a big competition like this, and it's hard to exactly predict how each and everyone react when you come into such a big tournament for your first game. But we're trying to stay relaxed, we're trying to stay focused, we're trying to push the girls and tell them every day that they are really in a good shape, and they are. So they can play this game with really good confidence, and it sounds a little bit crazy, but it is a football game, and football is what all these girls are good at, so they should go in, enter the field with really good self-confidence for this game. So just see it as any other match at all. So and that is the best. Don't think it's too big and start thinking too much. So just go there and do your job. That's the best thing to do.
Thank you, Coach. Question from Radha Gupta, Beyond 90. Asha, does the team recognize that you are role models to a lot of young girls in India who would be watching you? And does that get discussed in the dressing room?
You can talk about the role. You guys are role models for the. आप लोग पूरे देश के लिए role models हो. देश में जितने बच्चे लड़कियां हैं जो आगे football खेलना चाहते हैं, तो क्या ये अपने टीम में भी डिस्कस होते हैं, एंड आप लोग ये रोल को कैसे लेते हो एज अ टीम एंड एज इंडिविजुअल्स?
या एक्चुअली हम लोग आपस में भी बात करते हैं, क्योंकि हम लोग जब टीम हमें कैंप के बाद जब अपने अपने घर जाते हैं, तो मैं उनको बोलती हूँ कि कहीं भी मतलब अपने घर के पास में कोई स्कूल में या कोई अकादमी में कोई बच्चे आते हैं, तो उनको सपोर्ट करने का और उनको फुटबॉल के बारे में जानने का. और मुझे स्पेशली मैं पेरेंट्स को भी रिक्वेस्ट करती हूँ कि उनको ताकि पता चले वुमेन्स फुटबॉल. और मतलब इंडिया में ऐसे लगता है कि फुटबॉल वुमेन्स को नहीं खेलना चाहिए, मतलब फुटबॉल मेन्स का गेम है. सो बहुत सारे चीज़ें होता है. सो इसलिए मैं हमेशा प्लेयर्स को भी इस बारे में बात करती हूँ कि आपके आसपास में कोई बच्चे खेलना चाहते हैं पर उनके पेरेंट्स सपोर्ट नहीं करते, तो उनके पेरेंट्स को भी वो चीज़ को समझाए और फुटबॉल में लेके आए, तो हमारे फ्यूचर के लिए भी बहुत बेटर हो सकते हैं.
Obviously, we do talk amongst ourselves about being role models to young girls who want to take up the sport. Even when we go back home in our towns and villages, there are little kids at different schools or academies who want to play football, both boys and girls, and we sometimes go and help them out, give them tips. They want to know different things about football, and we tell them about them. There's a big perception in many parts of the country that women should not be playing football. We try as much as we can to request the parents to help their kids, especially their girl children, to come into the beautiful game and play it. And we try to inspire as many little girls as we can to take up the sport.
Asha, there's one more question from you for you from an AFC editor, Vinashal. Some of your teammates who play for Gokulam are familiar with some of the Iran players because they played in the 2021 AFC Women's Club Championship. Have you talked to them about this? Has that played a role in your strategy for the game?
I don't think so.
इस बारे में
मुझे मुझे इतना नहीं पता कि उस ईरान की क्लब में कितना नेशनल टीम के प्लेयर खेले थे ये सब चीज़ें. पर हाँ, आई थिंक कि 4-5 प्लेयर के बारे में हम लोग ने बात किया था कि अच्छा खेलते और उनका ये सारे गेम प्ले स्टाइल ये सब के बारे में. बट मुझे इतना भी नहीं पता कि उन कितना प्लेयर्स एग्जैक्टली कितना प्लेयर खेल रहे हैं. और मैंने उस टीम में खेला भी नहीं था गोकुलम में, सो
I did not play for Gokulam in those matches, so I am not exactly aware of how many of their players are in the national team, but we have obviously spoken about the national team players of Iran, how they play, their key players and their playing style, and we are planning for the match.
Thank you, Asha. Question for the coach. Coach, this goes beyond the football pitch basically. What kind of an impact do you think India competing in this tournament have on the future of women's football in the country?
Yeah, if we have a successful tournament, I think it will have a huge impact on the future. This is a big country, and I know that you will always have players enough to have good grassroots football and good football in the academies and so on. And hopefully, it's really got an upswing if we have a successful tournament, and that can make India even stronger on the world scene in the future. That's my hope.
Thank you, Coach. We have a question from Mrinal from The Bridge. Asha, is the team feeling any added pressure because of playing this at home, or is that just an inspiration for you guys to do even better?
Yeah, मुझे लगता है कि कोई भी टूर्नामेंट या कोई भी चैंपियनशिप खेलते हैं तो हमें मुझे कभी ऐसा फील नहीं होता है कि मैं बहुत इजीली ले रही हूँ या मुझे बिल्कुल प्रेशर नहीं है या मैं भी समटाइम मुझे थोड़ा सा प्रेशर भी होता है थोड़ा सा नर्वस भी होता है फिर भी मैं हमारे क्राउड के सामने खेलने में और मुझे मज़ा आने वाले हैं क्योंकि मैंने लाइफ में पहली बार इतना बड़ा टूर्नामेंट अपने होम क्राउड में खेलने वाले हैं सो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगेगा और आई होप कि बाकी ही मेरे टीम में सबको भी कंफर्टेबल लगेगा कि अपनी कंट्री की ग्राउंड पे खेल रहे हैं और पूरा कंट्री हमारे लिए सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं और हाँ कोविड की वजह से हमें ग्राउंड पे एंट्री नहीं है फिर भी सारे सोशल मीडिया में और टीवी में बहुत लोग हमारे सपोर्ट करने वाले हैं सो मैं बहुत खुश हूँ पर हम लोग मैं प्रेशर तो नहीं हूँ
There's no such pressure as such. Obviously, going into any tournament or any match, there's a combination of pressure and excitement, but that's normal. Obviously, playing at home, because of COVID restrictions, we can't have fans in the stadiums, but we do feel all their support on social media and all the other platforms, and we do hope they keep watching our games and keep supporting us. We don't take much pressure, but we will try to give our best.
We see a couple of more questions about Iran from IMNA Iran, as well as from Sports Action. Guys, the coach has already talked about the match at the beginning of this conference, so please refer to the video when we share that with you. There's a question from Times of India. Gaurav Gupta asks, Asha, how difficult is it to motivate the players in the bio bubble?
Starting में मैं खुद को भी थोड़ा difficult लगा और player को मतलब team को भी थोड़ा सा difficult तो होता है कि bio bubble में रह के practice करना ये सब चीजें but हमें इस level में खेलना है और अपने country को proud feel करवाना है तो कुछ चीजें हमें sacrifice करना भी बहुत important है वो हमेशा मैं प्लेयर को भी बताती हूँ कि हमें कभी कभी खुद के लिए और अपने कंट्री के लिए बहुत सारी चीज़ें सेक्रीफाइस करके आ रहे हैं सो इतना टाइम हमें बायो बबल में रह के और अपने कंट्री के लिए सेक्रीफाइस करने में मुझे इतना प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुआ और मुझे लगता है कि बाकी प्लेयर को भी इतना प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुआ क्योंकि हमने बहुत सारे इस पीरियड में हमने बहुत सारे प्लेयर्स का बर्थडे साथ में मनाया और हमने बीच बीच में बहुत सारे फन गेम और मतलब खुद को और सारी टीम को और सब मिलके खुश रखने के लिए खुद ने बहुत सारे मोटिवेट किया था इसलिए मुझे इतना डिफिकल्ट नहीं लगा था कि बायो बबल में रह के प्रैक्टिस करने
It was a bit difficult at the start when the bio bubble began, when we began to train. But obviously, we all understand that we play this sport for the love of the game and for love of our country. And we make our sacrifices for the country and for the game. So we do not have any problem with regards to staying within a bio bubble and operating from within. Obviously, from time to time we do need certain activities to take our mind away from maybe football or the bubble. So we do celebrate, if somebody has a birthday, we celebrate it, or we sometimes have some fun games between ourselves to keep everyone happy and motivated. So no, we don't have any problem with the bio-bubble as such.
We only have time for two more questions, so I'll take them right now. The first one is to the coach. Coach, are there any injury concerns, availability concerns ahead of your first game against Iran?
No, I think all the 23 players that are here should be fit. So I think we can make the choice the way we want.
And the second one, and I'll take the liberty of translating this for Asha. Asha, kafi logo ne aapke support mein banners banaye hain, artwork banaye hain. Chiranjeet pooch rahe hain fan garage se, aap unke bare mein kya bolna chahengi? Aur generally jo bhi aapko support karna chahte hain pure desh se, unke liye agar aapko kuch bolna ho end mein.
Main apne banner ko dekh ke jis din maine dekha tha yahan pe Mumbai mein, jab hame airport mein landing hua, usse bahar nikalte hue humne अपने पिक्चर देखा और बाकी प्लेयर्स को भी देखा, तो मैं बहुत खुश थे जो जिस हमें इस टूर्नामेंट के लिए जो हमें इंतज़ार कर रहे थे और बहुत क्लोज में थे, और मेरा हार्ट बहुत तेज होने लगा, मतलब धड़कने लगा. और मैंने कुछ प्लेयर के साथ भी शेयर किया था, क्योंकि हमें बस में भी AFC का लोगो और हमारे कंट्री का फ्लैग पिक्चर देखते हुए हमें भी मैं बहुत खुश थे. और फिर भी मतलब ऐसे लग रहा था कि जल्दी आए उस दिन, कि हमें जल्दी खेलने को मिले ऐसे. पर मैं जो भी हमें सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं और जिसने भी वुमेन्स फुटबॉल के लिए इतना हेल्प किया है, उन लोगों को थैंक यू बोलना चाहती हूँ कि और हमेशा हमारे सपोर्ट कीजिए, और हम कोशिश करेंगे कि इस लेवल से और बेटर खेलने के लिए हमेशा हार्डवर्क करते रहें.
When we landed in Mumbai and we were on the way to our hotel from the bus, we saw all the banners with our pictures and with the India logo all over the city. We felt really happy. In fact, for myself, if I speak for myself, my heartbeat went up seeing all those banners, and I shared with all the players as well my feelings, and we all felt like the match day couldn't come any sooner. We wanted to play our first match right away, and it was a really motivating effect for all of us. And I'd like to thank all our supporters, all the people who have supported us, our team, and I'd like to ask them to keep supporting us, and we'll keep working hard for you.
Thank you, Asha. Thank you, coach, and all the very best for the whole tournament. I hope you do really, really well. And thank you for all the media delegates for joining in and asking your questions. We tried our best to basically get all of your questions answered. If I missed any, I apologize. Please join in again for the press conference of IR Iran in another